Y'all hear this? Do y'all have y'all Bibles today?
Be transformed by the renewing of your mind. And you ain't gonna be transformed by the renewing of your mind until you get in the Word of God.
The Kingdom Agenda Worship Center.
Kingdom Building.
Hallelujah.
Join us today as we seek to divide the Word.
The Word of God.
It's inspired by God. Every scripture, every word, every and, it, but, so, can, it's all been breathed on by the Holy Ghost.
It's a life-giving Word.
How can you get instructions if the Word of God is not being divided correctly in the name of the Lord? Hallelujah.
And now, Senior Pastor Felicia Hamilton.
Live by bread alone.
But by every word
that proceeded out of the mouth of God.
Thank you, Lord God.
For the word of God.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
You may be seated. Turn your Bibles to Joel chapter 2. Hallelujah, God. Oh, come on, can we give the Lord a hand tonight? Hallelujah, God. Thank God for his goodness and mercy and grace tonight. In the name of the Lord. I don't know about you, but I can't wait till Sunday. It's like, God, I'm going to get it now. It's like there's so many benefits and there's so many promises in the Word of God. And God, I got a couple of them, but how many of you know I want them all before we come back? I don't know about you, but I want to taste and see that the Lord is good. I want to have so much. Yes, he is. Oh, hallelujah, somebody. How many of you want to taste and see that the Lord is good? I want to get so full of God. To when I say, God, that's enough. Please, God, I can't handle you no more. Oh, hallelujah, somebody. See, you got to get there. You got to hunger and thirst. You got to do something different and get a different result. You can't do the same thing and try to get a different result. You got to hunger and thirst after righteousness. But God, we give you praise. Oh, we give you glory in this place. And we give you honor. We give honor to the Spirit of Christ, the Holy Ghost. That's his name. We give honor to the Holy Ghost tonight. And we say, God, breathe on us, Holy Ghost. Breathe on us, Holy Ghost. Breathe on us, Holy Ghost. Oh, God, hallelujah. We give you all praise. Come on, I know you got your Bibles, but just stretch your hands out. And lift your head and tell the Holy Ghost to breathe on you. Come on, tell the Holy Ghost, breathe on the Holy Ghost. Come on, tell the Holy Ghost, breathe. Come on, ask him, say, breathe. On me, Holy Ghost. Oh, because we need him, we need him, we need him, come on, we need him, come on, come on. Stretch your hands out and say, breathe on me, Holy Ghost. Come on, mean it from your heart. He will not withhold nothing good from us. Come on, tell. He won't withhold of him. It's a good thing, and he won't withhold him good. So tell him all, breathe on me, Holy Ghost. Oh, it's going to be, it's a shifting in the atmosphere. It's the shifting that's going to happen in the kingdom of agenda. We going to get the Holy Ghost with fire! Right now. And I'm not letting it down, Lord. The Holy Ghost is good. for the Holy Ghost to breathe on us. Not later, but right now. Not later, but right now. Come along right now. I need the Holy Ghost. Too much going on out there. The Holy Ghost. Yes. Too many after me. Yes. I need the Holy Ghost. Yes. Too many people want to see me fall. Yes. I need the Holy Ghost. Yes. I need the Holy Ghost. Yes. Thank you. Oh, you got more. Oh, God. Oh, God. Believing that he's not going to leave us the way we came in. Yes. But we're going to be changed. Yes. Thank you, God.
Thank you.
In Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Joel chapter 2. Hallelujah.
Glory.
Oh, somebody shout glory up.
Glory.
Come on, somebody shout glory up.
Glory.
Come on, somebody shout glory up in this.
Glory!
Somebody shout glory up in this.
Glory!
Thank you.
Thank you.
Oh, my God.
Glory!
Oh, I don't want to stop. Oh, Jesus. Yeah, hallelujah. Give you all praise. See, when we come to the house of the Lord, He wants us to give him all praise, all glory, and all honor. He wants us to come in expecting him to do something, to do make a change in our lives. He don't want us leaving out the way we came in. He wants us to be changed and our hearts and our minds and our soul and our spirit. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Can somebody thank the Holy Ghost? Come on, you might have not have him now, but you're going to get him. If you keep coming and if you keep grabbing at him, and don't let go until you get him. I want all the benefits. I want all the blessings. And I want my inheritance. Oh, hallelujah, somebody. Why? Because we have a redemptive right to receive what God has promised. Tell your neighbor, I got a redemptive right to receive the blessings of the Lord. I have a we've been redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. So I have a redemptive right to receive whatever Christ has for me. Thank God for his goodness and mercy and grace. We will try this one more time. Joel chapter 2. Amen. Let's go to it tonight. In the name of the Lord.
Joel chapter 2. Blow the trumpet in Zion. Sound the alarm on my holy hill.
Blow the trumpet in Zion. Sound the alarm on my holy hill. See, Zion was the hill of Jerusalem on which the city of David was built. One day we're going to get back there. How many know it's going to be a new Jerusalem? In the name of the Lord, can somebody say hallelujah?
Hallelujah.
All right, but go on. This right here, Joel, this is a warning, and it is a judgment and on the nation of Israel. But God still giving Israel a second chance to come back to him once again. And it's just like with us. He's giving us a second chance to come back to him. But this time he wants us to come back right. Go ahead, Pastor.
Let all who live in the land tremble, for the day of the Lord is coming.
All who live in the land tremble. He says, work out your salvation with what? Fear and trembling. Come on, Pastor.
It is close at hand.
Uh-huh.
A day of darkness and gloom.
The day of the Lord is coming. He says, it is close at hand. If it was close back then, it's showing up closer right now. How many know you just feel it? You know he's just coming any day. And you begin to see God's people know that his time is near because he's getting us ready. He's cleaning us up. He's calling us into a sacred fast. And to humble ourselves and pray and seek his face. Go ahead, Pastor.
It is close at hand, a day of darkness and gloom, a day of clouds and blackness. Like dawn spreading across the mountains, a large and mighty army comes, such as never was of old, nor ever will be in ages to come. Before them, fire devours. Behind them, a flame blazes.
Uh-huh.
Before them, the land is like the Garden of Eden. Behind them, a desert waste.
My God.
Nothing escapes them. They have the appearance of horses. They gallop along like cavalry. With a noise like that of chariots, they leap over the mountaintops. Like a crackling fire consuming stubble. Like a mighty army drawn up for battle.
This is what the fire sounds like. Go ahead.
At the sight of them, nations are in anguish. Every face turns pale. They charge like warriors. They scale walls like soldiers. They all march in line, not swerving from their course. They do not jostle each other. Each marches straight ahead. They plunge through defenses without breaking ranks. They rush upon the city. They run along the wall. They climb into houses like thieves. They enter through the windows. Before them, the earth shakes. The sky trembles. And the sun and moon are darkened. And the stars no longer shine.
See, that's in the book of Revelation right there. Amen. Go ahead.
The Lord thunders at the head of his army. His forces are beyond number. and mighty are those who obey his command.
Thank you, Jesus.
The day of the Lord is great. It is dreadful. Who can endure it?
Who can endure it? That's why we got to get saved. But underline this right here, verse 12. Go ahead, Pastor.
Even now declares the Lord, return to me with all your heart, with fasting and weeping and mourning.
He says, now I declare, return to me with all your heart. We were just learning about on Saturday how to let God arise in your heart. Go ahead, Pastor.
Rend your heart and not your garments. Mm-hmm. Return to the Lord your God, for he is gracious and compassionate, slow to anger, and abounding in love.
Yes, he is.
And he relents from sending calamity.
In other words, he don't want to see no one perish, but he want all to have eternal life. Hallelujah, somebody. Go ahead.
14. Who knows? He may turn and have pity and leave behind a blessing. Mm-hmm. Grain offerings and drink offerings for the Lord your God. Blow the trumpet in Zion. Declare a holy fast. Call a sacred assembly.
My God.
Gather the people. Consecrate the assembly. Bring together the elders. Gather the children, those nursing at the breast. Let the bridegroom leave his room and the bride her chamber. Let the priests who minister before the Lord weep between the temple porch and the altar. Let them say, spare your people, O Lord. Do not make your inheritance an object of scorn, a byword among the nations. Why should they say among the peoples, where is their God?
Where is their God? So God is calling us. It's so ironic. And before I had called a holy fast, I didn't even know about this chapter right here or anything like that. You know, amen. I knew what God wanted me to do as far as Holy Ghost power. Amen. Had nothing to do with this chapter. I didn't even read this chapter. But then when I read the chapter and God says, this is for the people, I said, God, this right here is a confirmation that you want us to go on a fast. And it got to be a different kind of fast than what we do in the beginning of the year. This type of fast is rendering your heart and making it sacred unto the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. I believe with some of us, this is going to be our last chance to get it right with God. He says, I don't want your garment. He says, render your heart. In other words, I don't want your clothes and you dancing before me. I want your heart this time. Because you dancing before me, but you still got a lot of sin on the inside. Hallelujah. I just want them, y'all. I'm just hungry for them. I want it all. I can't wait till Sunday. I can't wait till the next. I want them now, because Sunday may not come. Tomorrow may not come. But I know I want to be so saturated with the Holy Ghost. I got to go up to meet him when he come in the air in the name of the Lord. He's here. He wants to change the atmosphere in the kingdom agenda. He's getting us ready for his coming because he's ever so near. That's why he says, come, come, repent of your sins. Call a holy fast. Let the pastors, the prophets, go before the pews and cry out for the people because they're still not listening. Go ahead, Pastor.
Verse 18. Then the Lord will be jealous for his land and take pity on his people. The Lord will reply to them, I am sending you new grain. I am sending you grain, new wine and oil, enough to satisfy you fully.
When we repent, he'll give us whatever we need, and he will satisfy us fully to where we don't want no more. Go ahead, Pastor.
Never again will I make you an object of scorn to the nations. I will drive the northern army far from you, pushing it into a parched and barren land, with its front columns going into the eastern sea, and those in the rear into the western sea. And its stench will go up. Its smell will rise. Surely he has done great things. Be not afraid, O land. Be glad and rejoice. Surely the Lord has done great things.
Go ahead.
Be not afraid, O wild animals, for the open pastures are becoming green. The trees are bearing their fruit.
Now you notice at the beginning there was destruction. But then when they repent and turn from their wicked ways, now everything is starting to get green again. Everything is starting to flourish. And this is what happens when we repent and turn from our wicked ways and stop living this worldly life. Then our land will be healed. He will hear from heaven. He will forgive our sin. And he will heal our land. Go ahead, Pastor.
The trees are bearing their fruit. The fig tree and the vine yield their riches. Be glad, O people of Zion. Rejoice in the Lord your God, for he has given you the autumn rains in righteousness. He sends you abundant showers, both autumn and spring rains, as before. The threshing floors will be filled with grain. The vats will overflow with new wine and oil.
That's the New Jerusalem.
I will repay you for the years the locusts have eaten.
Y'all need to underline that today. And in other words, God said, I'm going to give you double for your trouble. Go ahead, Pastor.
I will repay you for the years the locusts have eaten. The great locusts and the young locusts. The other locusts and the locust swarm. My great army that I sent among you. You will have plenty to eat until you are full. And you will praise the name of the Lord your God, who has worked wonders for you. Never again will my people be shamed.
That's when the new covenant happened. And in the blood covenant, where he says, I will never put those to shame who trust in my name. Go ahead, Pastor.
Then you will know that I am in Israel, that I am the Lord your God, and that there is no other. Never again will my people be shamed.
Somebody say never.
Never.
That's if you're in him now.
Yeah.
Oh, hallelujah, somebody.
Hallelujah.
Go ahead, Pastor.
28. And afterward.
Oh, underline this, church.
And afterward, I will pour out my spirit on all people.
Mm-hmm.
Your sons and daughters will prophesy.
Underline it and shout
hallelujah.
Your old men will dream dreams.
Mm-hmm.
Your young men will see visions.
Mm-hmm.
Even on my servants, both men and women.
Thank you, Jesus.
I will pour out my spirit in those days.
Can we shout hallelujah in this place? Uh-huh.
I will show wonders in the heavens and on the earth. Blood and fire and billows of smoke. The sun will be turned to darkness and the moon to blood before the coming of the great and dreadful day of the Lord.
Now that's talking about when we're coming back with him. Amen. Amen. We're already in heaven when it's taking place. Go ahead, Pastor.
And everyone.
Somebody say everyone.
Everyone.
Somebody say everyone.
Everyone.
Underline this in your Bible.
And everyone who calls on the name of the Lord will be saved.
Oh my God, say hallelujah, somebody.
For on Mount Zion and in Jerusalem, there will be deliverance.
My God, thank you, Jesus.
As the Lord has said, among the survivors whom the Lord calls.
On those who survive the great tribulation, they call on the name of the Lord and they shall be saved. Even now, if we call on the name of the Lord, we shall be saved. Come on, somebody. He said he's going to pour out his spirit on men and women. Can somebody say thank you, Jesus?
Thank you, Jesus.
Why wouldn't we want that now? We can experience that right now. All we have to do is open up our heart render our hearts to God and our will and our way. He wants to fill us. He said, please let me in so I can show you my power and show you that you can be an overcomer. Hallelujah, somebody. I don't know about you, but I want it. I want it. I'm not going to stop until I get it. If you don't get it, that's your problem. But I got to get it. Tell somebody, I got to get him. Come on, slap somebody. Say, I got to get him. I got to get him. Come on, somebody. How many of them? What I got ain't enough. Don't get me wrong. Yeah, I'm saved. And yeah, I'm filled with the Holy Ghost. But being filled with the Holy Ghost is not a one-time thing. Like, I got it. I got it 10 years ago. I don't need it no more. No. It's a recurring thing. You have to be refilled on a daily basis. Hallelujah, somebody. Then you'll be able to cast out devils and lay hands on the sick, and they shall recover in the name of the Lord. Then you'll go out and preach the gospel of Jesus Christ with power and with the anointing.
Yes.
And you will save souls. For I see that, I want him. Oh, I got to have it, church. I got to have it. We're on a movement. When God gives me, tell me to preach on Holy Ghost power, then this chapter comes up. Oh my Lord, have mercy. I said, God, what are you telling us? You telling us, yes, we need to go on this fast, but this time it must be serious.
Yeah.
This time it got to be serious. Yeah. Amen. Because usually every month, you know, the first of the month in January, we just do the thing that we do. But no, this is a serious fast. In other words, when you get done with this fast, you ought to come out different. Come on, somebody. You ought to not be gossiping and all that same mess that you was doing before you begin the fast. You ought to be filled up with the Holy Ghost. He want to give him to us. He said he will not withhold no good. The Holy Ghost is good. The Holy Ghost is a gift. And he wants, don't you want everything that the daddy want to give him? I want it all. Come on, somebody. I want it all. And we got to, in order to get it all, we must put down our flesh and render our hearts to the King of Kings and the Lord. We must humble. Ours, you ain't going to get it no other way. You're not going to get it. And God want to give it to us. He does. He's a good and gracious God. And he loves us. And he's not going to stop. See, it's not for everybody in here.
Yes.
It's not for those that, well, you know, I can't pass. I can't. If you can't, don't tell nobody. Just don't do it. Don't ruin it for somebody else. Come, because somebody else is ready to go. And then by the time you get so negative, they're not going to want to do it no more. If you don't want it, then you don't have to have it. But be quiet about it. Let those who want it, let them get it. You just be quiet and sit back and watch God move. And then you're going to want it. And then it's going to be too late. Oh, it's going to be different this time. Oh, it's going to be different this time. Hallelujah, Jesus. We give God all praise and all glory. Because see, he's coming back, church. I can't say it enough. I can't. He's coming back. And he's coming back for a spotless church. And we got to get so filled up of him to where we can't even recognize our old man no more. Come on, somebody. How many know that old man is still in there? And it comes out every now and then. But we want to get so filled up that old man has to get permission to come out. He just don't come out. Come on, somebody, with an impulse. He got to get permission to come out. And then you say, no, get down, devil. I'm filled now. He said, resist the devil. And he'll flee from you. Don't you want more from God? Aren't you tired of this same old, waking up doing the same old thing? Doing the same old thing. Don't you want something different?
Yes.
Well, you got to do something different in order to get something different.
Amen.
The book of Job. The Hebrew word for Job is Yoel. It's Y-O-E-L. Book of Job. In other words, that Job means the Lord, Yahweh, is God. We're in chapter 2. The theme is the judgment and grace of God. The key words is great and awesome day of the Lord.
Yes.
Oh, great and awesome day. See, if you say this chapter is good news. If you're not, it's a dreadful time. Come on, somebody. You ought to be scared right now. Oh, hallelujah, somebody. But a lot of us come to church, but we don't listen. But oh, but when the Spirit falls down on this church, like never before, you're going to wish you was a part. You're going to wish you was a participator instead of a spectator. Oh, come on, somebody. You're going to wish that you would have fasted and prayed. Oh, because he's going to do something this time. What's the purpose of the book of Joel? To make clear the suffering of Israel because of her backsliding. That's number one. Number two, to assure her of God's blessings when he comes to repentance and obedience to his will. And to state again the blessing of future and eternal restoration under the Messiah. The scripture verse I got that coincides with that. I couldn't find no other, but this one fits just perfectly. Repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus, for the forgiveness of sins, of your sins. And what? And you will receive the gift of the what?
Holy Ghost.
All we got to do is repent and believe the gospel of Jesus Christ. And we will receive the gift. Somebody say it's a gift. And he wants to give it to us. He's just waiting. He says, see, a gift, you got to receive the gift. The hand is already extended. The gift of the Holy Ghost is already there. God's not going to force you to take it. He said, come and get it. It is right here. And see, when somebody give you a gift, how many of you know you got to take it? If somebody give you money, you got to take it. Otherwise, you're not going to get it, right? Amen. So it's like a gift. When God give us a gift, we got to take it. The hand is already there. He says, I've been waiting for you for years. When are you going to come get this gift out of my hand? He wants to give it to us. Amen. Oh, praise God. Hallelujah, somebody. Blow the trumpet. Joel intensifies his warning by referring to darkness and gloom in that first line. How many need a pen and paper? We need some pen and paper. Hallelujah. Is that Malcolm back there? Is that your guess? Are you new? Are you a new person? What's your name? Okay, that's why you was one of them. Malcolm and King. They all kind of like the same family. Amen. But you look nice, son. Look, he came prepared this time to church. That's what I'm talking about, son. Amen. Amen. Blow the trumpet. Joel intensifies. Anybody need any pen and a piece of paper? Please raise your hand. Amen. We're going to do announcements and offerings after. Amen. We just had to go to this first. Amen. Blow the trumpet. Joel intensifies his warning by referring to darkness and gloom. Oh, it's going to get rough. See, at one time they blow the trumpet, judgment coming. The second time they blow the trumpet, blessings coming. But see, when they blow the trumpet the second time, you should have repented. Come on, somebody. But that first blow the trumpet in Zion, there's a song, blow the trumpet in Zion, Zion, sound the alarm of my holy mountain. Well, anyway, that first trumpet blow is blowing because judgment is coming. It's coming. But then God gives Israel a second chance. Then the trumpet blows again. Then God declares the blessings that will come if you repent of your sins. All right. Darkness and gloom. Symbols of judgment and destruction. Judgment and destruction. That should be darkness and gloom. Judgment and destruction. The appropriate response to God's day of judgment. Listen, the appropriate response to God's day of judgment is what? Fear and trembling. We don't want to fall in that judgment. Fear and trembling. Fear and trembling. Fear and trembling. Number two, in verse 12, God tells Israel to what? Return to me with all your heart. Return to me with all your heart. Return to me. And see, it's not just for Israel. Listen, we were reading about, this is for us too. He's the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. He's telling Israel to return with all, he's telling us to return to me with all your heart. Hallelujah. Uh-huh. With what? Listen, God tells Israel to return to me with all your heart, with fasting. Uh-huh. Yeah, you got it. This is what we're going to be doing. And weeping. And mourning. Don't come fasting to me like you got it together. That's why you need to fast, because you don't have it together. Return to me with all your heart, with fasting and weeping and mourning. The prophet in verse 13 calls for broken and contrite hearts. C-O-N-T-R-I-T-E. Broken and contrite hearts. He would not despise. Contrite is feeling or expressing remorse. You're apologetic. You're sorry for your sin. You don't sin. See, you don't, you're not, you, you know, it's like a lot of times when we get caught, we say we're sorry. But the word of God says godly sorrow leads to repentance. That's before you get caught.
Yes.
See, because when you get caught, it's easy to say, I'm sorry, right? But wouldn't it be something that the Holy Ghost quicken you and convict you? And then you got to say, I'm sorry and forgive me, Lord, before you get caught? That's when you know the Holy Ghost working with you. Come on. And then you didn't get caught. But the fact that the Holy Ghost is just inside of you, you just cannot rest until you say, forgive me, God. Oh, hallelujah, somebody. Godly sorrow leads to repentance. Number four. Blow the trumpet in Zion.
Number three.
Oh, okay. I'm sorry. Lord, okay. You want to blow the trumpet a little bit more. All right. If the people, I'm just too excited. I'm sorry. All right, number three. If the people will turn from their sins. I'm glad y'all paying attention. If the people will turn from their sins to God, he will have pity on them. We want God to have pity on us. We want God to have mercy and grace on us. We want God to have pity on us. Why? So we can get to heaven. He don't have pity on us if we go into hell. Oh, come on, somebody. Oh, yes, I'm going to have pity on me, God, forever. He would have pity on them. It is God's character, listen, to show mercy and compassion. Mercy and compassion. It is God's character to show mercy and compassion to his people if they sincerely what? Repent. There you go. All right, this whole thing is repent. Turn from your wicked ways. Then you will receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. Sins, pity, mercy, compassion, repent. Number four, blow the trumpet in Zion. Declare a holy fast, not just fasting and waiting till 6 o'clock come that you can eat. No. Because see, when you, yeah, a lot of us be in the McDonald's drive-thru at 5 of 6. That's not a holy fast. See, if you do it like that, just go ahead and eat a burger at 3. You know what I'm saying? Because you ain't doing it right. Because if it's a holy fast, sometimes you go past 6 o'clock. Come on, somebody. Not too many of us, but I mean, I'm just saying, some of us. You know what I'm saying? But if you're fasting and can't wait to eat, then you're doing it for the wrong reason. So you might as well just go ahead and eat. Come on, somebody. Don't fool yourself. She's like, I can't. Oh, it's only 3 o'clock. And some of us just watch the clock. Don't you know when you watch the clock, it goes slower? Come on, somebody. You got to get busy, do something. That's why when you fast, you got to pray. You got to read. You got to do something, otherwise you're going to get a burger. Come on. You're going to get hungry. You're going to get headaches. You're going to get dizzy. You're going to pass out something. But when you're doing unto the Lord, you don't get dizzy. You don't get headaches. You don't. How many fast before? And you don't get, I'm talking about when you really do it unto the Lord. When you really do it unto the Lord, you don't feel nothing. People can cook in front of you. You can watch the cooking channel. You can watch somebody eat. It don't even fade. It's like God just shut you down. That's when you know it's God. Come on, somebody. And then after that third day, it seemed like it just get easy. Because that first day is like exorcism. Like an exorcism. Exorcism, amen. The second day is like civil a little bit. The third day, then you get on the track. You're like, okay, I can do this. I can do this. Amen. Then the fourth day, it gets like real super. Go on and put that hog in front of me. I ain't gonna touch it. Then that fifth day, you like Superman. Man. But that sixth day, you kind of start to get hungry. Okay, all right. I got seven. Then that seventh day, boy, you better throw down. Come on. You're gonna eat everything that's not nailed down. Amen. But be careful when you go on a holy fast like that. You eat slowly. Don't try to eat three big bags after the fast because you're gonna get sick. You'll get sick, amen. That's an absolute fast, though. That's when you're only drinking liquids. We're not talking about 6 to 6. That's for babies, but that's what we're going to do. We're babies. Amen. But when you go on the whole week, help us, Lord. Yeah. See, when you go without food for 7 days, God can help you with that, though. I went 12 days before, and that's about as far as I went, and that was as far as I wanted to go. Because I got hungry. Amen. But it was easy. I was chipper and all that. Until I seen a commercial. On the 11th day, I seen the commercial. I said, okay, on the 12th day, time's up. Amen. If I can do it, anybody can do it. Because I love to eat. Come on, somebody. I'm an eater. Amen. Anyway. All right. Blow the trumpet. Blow the trumpet in Zion. Declare a holy fast. Notice he said holy fast. Not just fast, a holy fast. Call a sacred. That's holy and deserving respect. Call a sacred assembly. Bring together the elders. Gather the children. Kids abusing. No, no one on that front. Those nursing at the breast. Call them, even the babies got fast. Let the priests who minister before the Lord, listen, weep between the temple porch and the altar. There should be Zion, holy fast, sacred, elders, children, nursing, weep, temple, and altar. Why should the priests who minister before the Lord weep between the temple porch and the altar? Let them say, spare your people, O Lord. Do not make our inheritance an object of scorn, a byword among the nations. Why should they say among the people, where is their God? Almost done. Number 5, when God's people humble themselves, not the world, his people. When God's people humble themselves, seek his face in prayer, and help me turn from their wicked ways. Help me, son. God hears from heaven. Check this out. Reverses his temporal judgment. He reversed the curse. Then he renews the land and pours out his blessing. Can somebody say hallelujah?
Hallelujah.
All right, and the lines is humble, seek, turn. Amen. Don't it feel good? Don't it? Do it feel good to y'all out there?
Yes.
It feels like we have some beautiful worship.
Thank you, Lord.
The Holy Ghost was in the house.
Thank you, Lord.
Got a new drummer, Mr. Travis.
Thank you, Lord.
Everyone was beating drums, so then I said, boy, you're going to make me come out my purse tonight. Help me pay you, boy. Help. Give me a dollar. Then, huh? You broke the drumstick? Hold it, your drumsticks, right? Thank you, Jesus. Well, I tell you what, where do you get them from? Sam Ash or whatever? We'll get you some more, okay? We'll get you some more. You got to show somebody how to look it, because, yeah, show somebody. I'll buy them, but show somebody, okay? You get so don't worry about it. You'll have more fun. Huh? What? What was it? It was the what? Is their kickstand? Is your kickstand? Huh? Is their kickstand? So you cost me money tonight. Mm-hmm. All right, well, whatever. See, they probably didn't really have nobody who knew how to play. I'm just saying. They just didn't have nobody. But Travis was on them drums. What are y'all giving up for Travis? Because I had to get my... Hey! Get my praise on. He's gonna get paid today. Yeah, I got some for you, Travis, at the church. Yeah. I didn't know you could play like that. Who brought you in here? Was it TJ? Who brought you to church? JK or TJ? Which one? Both of them? Yeah. Y'all got McDonald's at the church. Yeah. Mickey D's on the house. Amen. Praise God. Amen. I'm telling you, y'all sound real good. Amen. Pastor Gio was tearing it up on the keyboard. Minister Pizza brought it in. Yeah. Woo. Y'all was in there because y'all came here all upset. Feet hurt, back hurt. Tired from the day. I'm like, what's going on in this church tonight? We ain't did this before. Yeah, it's a new thing in the house now. Oh, yes, God. Thank God. So, Brother Travis, you're going to have to tell somebody, we need to look at that so we can go get it. They probably don't even use it with it. But we need it for our drama. Somebody say our drama. That's what I'm talking about. Number six, let's go on. In other words, okay, in other words, what? I done forgot all the stuff even there. Amen. That's really fine. When God's people humble themselves, seek his face in prayer, and turn from their wicked ways, God hears from heaven, reverses his temporal judgment, renews the land, and pours out his blessing. In other words, God answers. Mm-hmm. His people's humble prayers. See, they got to be humble in order for them to be answered. Don't be demanding God to do something. You will never get it. Never. And you owe me this. God don't owe you nothing but hell. Yeah. I deserve this. You don't deserve nothing but hell. Be careful how you go to God. In other words, God answers his people's humble prayers that come from repentant what? Hearts. Can't get away from that new Saturday. Hearts. I mean, it's all talking, it's just coincides with Jesus. Furthermore, persistent P-E-R, somebody say thank you, prophetess. P-E-R-S-I-S-T-E-N-T. Furthermore, persistent and sincere prayer for revival will result in the what? Somebody try again. It'll result in the what? Listen, furthermore, persistent and sincere prayer for revival will result in the
pouring out of the Spirit.
I'm so glad I didn't put no money on that tonight. I was just getting ready to. The outpouring of the Holy Ghost. The outpouring of the Holy Ghost. The outpouring of the Holy Ghost upon his people. The outpouring. We want it, y'all. We want to be like when they were in that upper room. Oh, Jesus.
Yes.
To tongues of fire fall on us. Ooh, Jesus. For revival will result in the outpouring of the Holy Ghost upon his people. Number 7 and verse 26, God says that never again will my people be put to what?
Shame.
Shame. Put it there. Shame. Never. His people now. Now, if you don't belong to them, you're going to be shamed for every day. But my people will never be put to shame. This promise is contingent, okay, listen, on God's people remaining humble. Oh, yeah. Humble and faithful to him. Only is contingent on if you're being humble and faithful to him. If they become arrogant and return to the paths of sin, who? Us. If they become arrogant and return to the paths of sin, God's blessings will be withheld. Listen. And his judgment will follow. So don't get it twisted. You become arrogant and return to the path of sin, and you don't get blessed no more. No judgment is coming on you now. Number 8, I will pour out my spirit on all people. See, FYI, please, when we read it. Number 9, the full realization of the outpouring of the Spirit. The full realization of this outpouring of the Spirit and the offer of salvation to all people will someday be followed by the end time cosmic signs. What's cosmic signs? When the sun, when the stars get to falling, and the moon turned dark, or the sun turned dark, the moon and the right. Earth and the clouds, they begin to flee. And the earth and the sky says, see ya, got to go. They get up and go, they get up and boogie, right, baby? Is that what you call it, boogie? Yeah, that's what they say. Amen. It just goes. Amen. Listen, the cosmic signs and the day of the Lord. I read it again. The full realization of the outpouring of the Spirit and the offer of salvation to all people will someday be followed by the end time cosmic signs and the day of the Lord. Check this out. Number 10, when examined in the light of biblical prophecy, worldwide conditions indicate that the time for these future events is near. Nigh, near is all the same. Nigh or near. Amen. Amen. Let's go. We're going to do FYI in the name of the Lord. We're going to stand up, but we're going to have to sit in here because we've got announcements and offering and many factors today. But let us all stand. Hallelujah. We've got visitors we need to acknowledge as well. Amen. Let us all stand. Hallelujah. And then Pastor Parable. I say we don't have our ladies tonight because, they got in trouble, y'all. They got in trouble. Yeah, they're stopping the other churches, stopping the bands, taking them out, and doing all kinds of stuff. So it always happens, doesn't it? Amen. Yeah. Yeah, but that's okay, but God's still filling the house.
Yes,
and he's going to fill it even more when we can become in one accord.
Yes.
And we fast and pray and we get in one accord. He can't help but to add to the house of the Lord. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, I don't know about you, but I'm so excited and I can't wait. Amen. Can't wait because he's doing it now.
Yes, he is.
He want to pour it out now.
Yes,
sir. Go ahead. Let's do FYI, please, sir.
FYI. Joel predicts a day when God would pour out his spirit on everyone who calls on the name of the Lord. This outpouring will result in a charismatic flow of the spirit of prophecy among God's people. Peter quoted this passage on the day of Pentecost, explaining that the outpouring of the spirit on that day was the beginning of the fulfillment of Joel's prophecy. This prophecy is an ongoing promise.
It's a what?
Ongoing promise.
It doesn't stop.
to all who accept Christ as Lord. For all believers can and should be filled with the Holy Ghost.
Are y'all reading this? Are y'all reading this? This is lining up with what we're doing.
Yes.
Go ahead, Pastor.
Joel envisions that one of the primary results of the outpouring of the Holy Ghost will be the impartation and release of prophetic gifts.
Mm-hmm.
The manifestation of the Spirit through his gifts makes known God's presence among his people.
See, when you get the Holy Ghost and the Holy Ghost begin to fall, God's going to bring manifestations. You ain't got to wonder, did I get it, or is God's Spirit really here? No, God know how to fill the house and show you his manifestations of his glory. I believe with all my heart, cancer going to be healed. I believe that God, I'm telling you, I just believe he's going to do a new thing. And let me tell you how I know. Pastor Mary was telling me that the people across the street, these people, and one of the commissioners, Pastor Brookins told her that the people across the street is mad. They upset with us. And I was like, well, for what? Guess why? Because they said when we didn't have no air, the windows was open and they could hear the service. And now that the windows is closed, they can't hear the service no more.
Wow.
So Brookins told them, well, their time of service is.
Yes.
And what commissioner was that that's really upset?
Commissioner Barron, he's on the board.
These people are angry. They're complaining because they made us have a church. You know, we're so loud, they had a church on their porch. You see what I'm saying? But now that the windows is closed, they was like, what's it? Did something happen in that church? They are upset. No, Pastor Brookins told them, well, their time is Saturday. They time, you know, she told them. Can you believe that? Wow. I laughed at that. I was like, oh my God. See, you just never know. Our church is bigger than we think it is.
Yes. Wow.
It's bigger than we think it is. Come on, somebody.
The manifestation of the Spirit through his gifts makes known God's presence among his people.
Mm-hmm.
The Apostle Paul declared that if the church prophesies, an unbelieving visitor will be compelled to exclaim, God is really among you.
Yeah.
Get ready, church.
Get ready, church.
Get ready, church.
Get ready, church.
The Holy Ghost is ready to breathe on us.
Yes.
Prepare your hearts, mind, and soul to receive what God has in store for his people.
Amen.
Come on, give it all to him. Come on, church. If it blows right now, if you were to die right now, do you know for sure that you will have eternal life? You may say, no, I don't know, but I know I want to go to heaven. If that's you, raise your hand and let's get you there. Amen. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, little baby. I see you. Thank you, son. God bless you. All right, with everybody's hands lifted, I'm so glad you're honest with yourself. Let's say this prayer together. Say, oh God.
Oh God.
I come to you.
I come to you.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Forgive me, Lord.
Forgive me, Lord.
Of all of my sins.
Of all of my sins.
Come into my heart.
Come into my heart.
Lord Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
I believe.
That God.
Raised Jesus Christ.
Raised Jesus Christ.
From the dead.
From the dead.
Just for me.
Just for
and
me.
And I confess.
And I confess.
With my mouth.
With my mouth.
That Jesus.
That Jesus
is Lord.
Is Lord.
Thank you, God.
Thank you, God.
For waiting on me.
For waiting on me.
Today.
Today.
I am.
Saved.
Born again.
Born again.
And born to heaven.
And born to heaven.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
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 And amen. If you said that prayer, congratulations. You are now born again. Christ, old things has passed away. Behold, all things become new. Reach your hands towards me and let me bless you. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord keep you. May the Lord make his face shine upon you and give you his peace. Now bless us, Lord God, with your precious Holy Ghost. Father, you said it's a gift. And your word says that you will not withhold nothing good from us. So endow us with your presence.
Yes.
Fill us with your Holy Ghost.
Yes.
That we may witness for you on this earth. Thank you, God.
Thank you, God.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. And amen. Love somebody in the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. All right.
Thank you for joining us in the Spirit. Know that Jesus Christ loves you and desires for you to have eternal life.
May you be encouraged by God's word.